Well, I'm here in Shanghai to actually get an insight into the brand of MG and its parent company, SAIC. And we've had a look at the plant, and today we're out here on the test track to actually get our hands behind the wheels of some of their cars to feel and experience what the product is really like.
But before I dive into our test drive, let me give you a little more information on MG. We caught up with Rajiv Chhaba, President and CEO, MG India, to tell us what their plans are.
People in India don't know MG. MG, though it's a 94-year-old British brand and iconic brand of its time, but as far as India is concerned, for most of the people it's new. Though, by the way, as you know, more than 300 vintage cars are there of MG, MG fame. But now we need to start a fresh and new innings. So, without getting into too many words and marketing cliches, I would say that we will try to exceed the expectations of consumers, or whatever expectations they have from us, and we are going to make sure that on all the pillars of our proposition, like product side, consumer experience side, and product assurance side, we try to do something better than what normally consumers expect in India. Our first car is going to be a SUV C-segment. And it's dimensions wise it's really big, hopefully we are able to provide the kind of comfort, the kind of performance, and the features and the overall package to consumer which is relevant to the Indian consumer's taste.
He also gave us a few other insights.
If you look at the whole car ownership experience and car delivery, everybody can talk theoretically about, okay, we want to be the best, or that's how we want to deliver. But detail is in execution. So I think this is what I would like to do in our company, that our culture is such that we are able to deliver it and execute it, what we are saying, and we walk the talk. So coming to dealers, our philosophy is very simple, that we will have very less number of dealers, but good quality dealers who can grow with us. But in terms of touch points, in terms of access to consumer, to the workshop and showrooms, touch points will be many. So as an example, our target right now is that we will have not more than 40-45 dealers in the country, but we will have 100 touch points in terms of workshops and showroom and experience centers to start with. And even after 5 years, I would like to say that we don't want to increase this number from 40-45 to maybe 50 or 60. But the touch points can be 500.
So basically, each dealer will get a larger area.
Huge area to operate, profitability, viability, the discounting, you know, all those things are very important, and dealers will grow, their families will grow, so they can grow with us. So I think we are going to have a very different kind of a philosophy than some of the other OEMs in the market.
So tell me, these 100 touch points to begin with, they will all have service, so it will be sales to service?
Yeah. Absolutely. Not 100 touch points. Okay. The workshops probably maybe 60-65 in phase one. We are also thinking of some startup solution for augmenting this workshop network, but details are being chalked out, so I can't say it right now. And likewise, we will have almost 70-80 touch points on the showroom side and experience side.
The idea of being in Shanghai was to experience what brand MG can bring to the table. And it was done by experiencing not only the MG cars, but also cars from the other marques owned by SAIC, which MG can draw from. The SAIC test track is impressive to say the least. Spread over 5.7 square kilometers, the facility has 60 kilometers of road and 67 different driving conditions for testing cars. First up, we drove the MG 6.
So this is fun. We're on a circuit where I'm trying to drive flat out and talk to the camera, and it's tightening up around me. But I have to say that this car handles pretty amazingly.
Although the steering wasn't completely feelsome, it was pretty quick to react, and the car darted through the course with a reassuring ease.
This is a hybrid, I have to say. I've given it a try around the track and it is pretty darn good. Performance, tick. Handling, tick. So it is ticking all the right boxes. But now let's get a closer look at the car and at the quality that MG also offers. Let's take a look around the car.
Styling is definitely modern and finish across the car is up to the standard we've come to expect.
So in the interest of safety, so that the cameraman doesn't get knocked over on the test track with people driving around, I'm sitting actually on the passenger side for a change. to talk about the interiors of the car, because we really want to get a feel of how the quality of MG is going to be when it comes to India. And I have to say that it's quite impeccable. Materials used across the car are really nice. As far as equipment goes, you really get everything king size. Look at the large screen that's here in the central display. And everything feels good to touch, tactile, the knobs, the switches, the buttons. So you can really expect a good level of quality from the interiors when they come to India.
Up next, we took a look at Marvel X, SAIC's all-electric vehicle that boasts of a lot of features, including semi-autonomous driving.
Okay, so what we're going to test now is the autonomous driving. The car is now maintaining its speed, following the lanes, and pretty much driving on its own. Look, no hands, no feet. But it can only do this as long as there are lane markings. So, now that the lane markings are getting over, it wants me to take over.
Apart from the level 2 autonomous drive on the go, the Rui Marvel X also has the auto parking feature. So in the first part of the day, we were impressed by the dynamic capabilities of their cars. Then we were shown that their cars are future ready. And for the last part, it was a safety test. On a wet tile surface that simulated icy conditions, we were shown that safety is also a high priority on the company's list of must-haves for its consumers. In fact, their cars are scoring 5-star ratings in China, and MG's promise is when our regulations are in place, their cars will deliver the same in India. Now in India, it is the backseat that takes precedence. So when we checked out the Rui ERX5, it was the backseat that I hopped into.
So I'm seated at the back of this RX5. Now here's another thing that we've found about all the cars that actually we've driven today is that rear seat space is actually very good. I may not be the ideal height for a depiction, but as you can see, there's loads of legroom for even a tall person over here. Lots of headroom. The seat is nice and wide, so it's a roomy, spacious back seat. I have my aircon vents. I have a fantastic panoramic sunroof. So even as a backseat passenger, this car is a really nice place to be. And yeah, expectations are good.
I also took a look at the HS, which is an SUV about the size of the one we will see in India. First impressions are good ones, and this feels like a car that would compete with any of the European cars. The design is a bit of a mix with bits from Mazda, Porsche and even Hyundai thrown in, but overall it works surprisingly well, and I think the silhouette is sporty and neat. Inside, the cabin is impressive too. The red leather won't be to everyone's taste, but quality levels make me go nice. I noticed that the high-quality steering wheel, the power window switches, and the buttons along the gear selector all seem to be taken from the Volkswagen parts bin. Yes, SAIC does have a tie-up with Volkswagen and even GM in China, and can draw on a lot from there. Even in the back seat, the HS was spacious, and the ride quality was supple, making it a very comfortable place to be.
Well, I spent 2 days here in Shanghai getting a deep dive into brand MG and its parentage. We visited the parent facility, SAIC. And what I learned there is that this company is growing really rapidly. What I also learned is that MG has a bank of platforms that it can draw on between sister companies and tie-ups to bring products that are suitable for the Indian market. Of course, we know that the first product is going to be an SUV. And after having driven a few of the products here at the proving ground today, what I've learned is that we can expect a spacious product with good quality interiors, good driving dynamics, and one that's packed with features. Now, MG have also been telling us that they are promising value to the Indian customer and a good cost of ownership. So my expectations from this brand are running really high, and I have to say I'm impressed with what I've seen so far. If you're impressed with what you've seen so far as well, do remember to leave your comments on this video. If you've liked the video, do hit the subscribe button and the bell icon for notifications.